Hey guys, Tech Timmy here. So in this video, I am going to be testing out this Netgear Wi-Fi extender slash USB adapter that is supposed to be able to extend my signal. Right now I'm getting exactly this, so roughly about 400 megabits per second download and 57 megabits per second upload speeds from my router, which is in the next room. So my bedroom is one room over from where the router's at. I have 1 gigabit Ethernet service, so kind of a bummer that it's not even getting me to 500 megabits per second. So I'm going to try this guy here, this network extender, and we're going to set it up right now and see if it gives us a little speed boost. I'm a little skeptical because others online have had kind of mixed reviews with this. So basically what we're going to do is we need to install the software off of this thumb drive that shipped with the product here. So I'm going to stick that in my computer and we're going to give it a go. So here's my Dell computer and we are going to insert that guy right there. So I inserted that into the computer. My virus software pops up and says that I have an external drive detected, which is fine. Oh, sorry. So there it is. So there's the program that is on the thumb drive. So we're gonna actually click on that and install it, and then it's gonna say, "Do you want us to allow this to make changes to your device?" To your device. Interestingly, that the this A8000 is a little bit different than what it says on my package here. So hopefully I've got the right drive. So this is X3000, whatever. So maybe 8000 is more than 3000. So maybe this is an upgraded version. So we're just gonna say yes. And yep, so it is. So we do have a Netgear prompt. So we have got the right software apparently. So we're just gonna do the install here. And pardon my jiggy hand. This is the only way that I know how to actually do the install at this point. So let's just get the software installed here real quick. So we need to accept the terms, and then we're going to say next, and then we're going to do the install, and then I'll be quiet because I may fast forward this part. Okay, so yeah, so now it prompts us, yes, I want to disable the other Wi-Fi adapters. I do think I have an additional adapter that I was using from my previous setup. So I am going to say, yeah, let's just disable that so there's no conflicts. I would say just accept the defaults for this. So we're going to say next, and then install Shield Wizard completed. Now, presumably, I can go ahead and plug in my device and it will detect it. So hang on. So here we go. We're going to take the extender, and I'm going to plug it right in to my old PC here. I'm actually going to take out the thumb drive because presumably we don't need that anymore. And then I'm going to stick that right up on top of the PC there. And I'm going to insert the USB connector. And there's that. And there's that. And this gives you the capability to actually pop it up. So pop up the antenna. So I'm actually going to put it that so it's standing tall, and then we'll come back up to the computer here. It basically wants you to plug in to your existing Wi-Fi network, and mine just seemed to have disappeared. Now they're back. Okay. So it wants you to plug into your existing Wi-Fi network. So, and I'm going to choose my 5G network because it's an order of magnitude faster than my Tatooine is my 2.4 gigahertz network, and my 5 gigahertz network is named Coruscant. So it does, you don't pick the Netgear ones, which is interesting. You pick your actual 5G network, and so we're going to connect it up. And so this should connect without any problem. I don't think it'll make me enter my password either. Let's just wait and see if we can get connected back up here. So again, this is my existing 5G network, so secured, can't connect to the network. I don't know why it's saying that. Well, it looks like I'm already connected to Tatooine. So let's close out here. Let's disconnect from Tatooine. And then we're gonna connect into Coruscant. And now that time it looks like it did connect. No Wi-Fi networks found, weird. Okay, so there's some general weirdness happening. So Coruscant is saying no internet now. which is very odd. All right, so now, it says it's connected. So there's a little bit of weirdness after you plug in this network adapter. So you may experience this as well. And what I also notice is that if I pull the adapter out, all my Wi-Fi networks disappear until I plug it back in. So I'm unable to do a real comparison here. But let's just go back to the computer, and I'm going to pull up speed test again, and just to kind of prove it out. The initial test that I did is super encouraging. Let's just, here we go. So we're going to pull up speed test, and that's already nice and zippy. I don't know if you noticed, and here we go. So now we're getting, 765 download and upwards of, it looks like to be close to 50 upload. So 765 download, close to 40.7 upload. So the upload speed is essentially the same, but the download speed, which is really what I care about, is significantly faster than when I ran the test without the adapter. So let's just test again. Let's see. And it seems to be fairly consistent. So before, I was getting quite consistently between 300 and call it 600 megabits per second. And now I'm upwards of around 800 megabits per second, which was just really cool. And it looks like my downloads are 800 megabits per second. It looks like my upload speeds are around, hovering around 40 megabits per second, which is fine. And I'll just do one last test just for sake of, you know, completeness here. And again, it's pushing 800, which is, that's really great for such an inexpensive device. So yeah, I would say if you're having network issues and you're not getting the full gig, if you know you're in the next room, say, or whatever, which I would not expect to get a full gig, I would definitely want it more than 400 megabits per second, 600 megabits per second, which is what this has allowed me to do. It's this guy here that I picked up off Amazon, and it talks about 6G, but I don't think, or sorry, 6E, I guess now. But I don't think 6E is ready for prime time yet. And actually, Verizon confirmed that basically 6E is, you know, I think if you're right on top of it, you can actually get 6E speed, something like that. But it's not really ready for prime time. So this is, my 5G connection is significantly faster using this device, probably 20 to 30% faster. So very cool. So I hope this video helped. If it did, please subscribe, and I hope to see you in the next one. Cheers.